A couple years ago, I purchased a GoPro HD Hero camera, and I love this camera. I purchased the helmet mount kit, which came with a head mount, a helmet mount, various quick release brackets, and some positioning brackets. But what it didn't come with was a tripod mount. And sometimes I like to, you know, take it off my helmet and put it on a tripod and film the end of a video. So instead of spending some more money to buy another tripod mount, I figured out how to make one using one of the extra flat mount brackets that GoPro sends with the kit. And it's worked out really well, and I'm going to show you how to make it in this video.
You'll need to select a piece of material that's at least 1/4 inch thick. I'm using aluminum because it's lightweight, easy to work with, and I had it laying around the shop. You could use steel or UHMW plastic or even a good hardwood. Your selected material needs to be at least 1/4 inch thick because most camera tripod mounting studs are slightly less than 1/4 inch tall. You'll also need a 13/64 drill bit and a 1/4 by 20 tap. If necessary, take your material and cut it into a small workable square. What you want is for one of the flat GoPro stick-on mounts to fit entirely on the square that you've cut out of your material. Once you've got your square piece of material that you're going to use for your mount, you need to find the center of it. Simply take a straight edge and connect two of the corners of the square and draw a line, then connect the opposite two corners and draw another line. Where the lines intersect is where you need to drill your hole, so take a center punch and make a mark on that intersection, and we're ready to drill. Technically, the correct drill bit for a 1/4 by 20 tap would be a number 7 wire gauge drill bit. But most people, myself included, don't have a full set of wire gauge drill bits laying around, but 13/64 is close enough to get the job done. Put a little bit of cutting fluid on your tap and then try to keep it as perpendicular to your material as possible and run the threads in. Now this step's really optional. At this point you could just stick the mount right to the base of material that you've cut and pretty much be done, but I like to take it a step farther and trace the outline of the GoPro mount onto the material that I've cut. Then we'll trim that base material to fit the contour of the GoPro mount. With the outline of the GoPro mount rough cut into your base material, go ahead and take a file or a grinder or whatever it is you want to it and smooth out all the edges. Once you've knocked off all the sharp edges on your base material, go ahead and pick your cleaner of choice and make sure the mounting surface is free of any dirt or oil or grime or anything that might keep that adhesive from sticking. Once you've got your base material clean, go ahead and peel off the backing on your GoPro quick release adhesive mount. Line it up carefully with your base material and then press it down. You want to make sure you get it aligned right, because once you push it down it's on forever, and you'll want to keep pressure with your palm on it for about 15 seconds just to make sure it fully adheres. This adhesive that they're using is amazing stuff and it will not come off.
Okay, so here's what's great about making a mount like this, a quick release tripod mount. You take your tripod's regular camera mount and you simply screw it to the bottom of the mount that you've made using the threads that we tapped in there with that 1/4 by 20 tap. So you kind of square it up a little bit. There you go. Mount it in the tripod. And then, let's say you were out riding and you got some good film on your GoPro and now you want to do some speaking into your GoPro for the end of the video or something, so you want to transfer it right to your tripod. Simply take it off of your helmet, clip it right into your tripod, and now you've got adjustability on your tripod there. But what I really have liked about this system is that the GoPro tripod mount utilizes a bracket like this with the threaded hole in the bottom of it. Now, utilizing this kind of bracket, where it's, you know, the quick release on there, you don't have to mess with unscrewing your GoPro. The other thing I found is that these little acorn nuts, sometimes on these screwed through mounts, do love to fall off, and they are small and can get lost. So I've really enjoyed just having one of the quick release mounts so that I can simply just take my GoPro off of whatever helmet I've got it on and quickly slap it into the tripod, and I can get all the adjustability I need and not even lose my setting on the GoPro, so that I could put it right back onto my helmet and take some more video if I wanted to from the helmet cam.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked what you saw, please take a moment and click the like or thumbs up button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Like votes and new subscribers really help encourage me to keep making these videos. Thanks.